You know what's cool? Doom. Doom is awesome. Who doesn't love Doom? Of course, Doom was introduced into the marketplace back in 1993 on PCs, and it quickly came to consoles, and it really revolutionized first-person shooters. Who didn't love playing as this Doom guy blowing through waves of demons on Mars? It was just a cool concept, and it worked really well. It was very over the top, very bloody, and very violent. And like I said, it made its way onto home consoles, and I did not have a PC to play PC games, but I did check out the home console versions. We, of course, got Doom on the Super Nintendo. It was on a red cartridge. Who doesn't like red cartridges? Of course, my beloved 32X even got a copy of Doom on it. Great game! It, you know, the sound was absolutely terrible, but it ran well, it played fun, and it looked pretty good as well. You also had the criminally underrated Doom 3 on the Xbox. Yeah, it was different, it was slower paced, but I liked the story-driven narrative of this game, and I think it's a really fun game. And then, of course, you had the masterpiece known as Doom 2016 on the PS4, the Xbox One PC, and then coming over to the Nintendo Switch. A game that I absolutely loved. It was one of my favorite games of 2016 on the PS4, one of my favorite games of 2017 on the Nintendo Switch. And sometimes with big video game franchises, movies come along of these video games. And let's be honest, most of the time they're not very good and ranging more into a guilty pleasure thing. There's a few video game movies that I enjoy watching from time to time. Things like Street Fighter the movie, you know, Raul Julia did really well in the role of M. Bison in it. The Mortal Kombat movies aren't too bad. And of course, we got a Doom movie before starring The Rock, and it wasn't great, but there was that cool first-person shooter segment part of it towards the end of the movie that I think a lot of people enjoyed. Well, people, not only are we getting a new Doom game this year with Doom Eternal potentially coming in 2019, but we're also getting a new Doom movie, and I don't think anyone expected this. And this is called Doom Annihilation that will be releasing in 2019. And a 30-second trailer went up for this, and a lot of people seem to be upset with it. So I started to watch this trailer, and I thought to myself, you know what? We should watch this trailer together. Let's analyze it. Let's talk about it, and let's just see why Doom Annihilation 2019, it just looks like a piece of shit. Like, I don't think there's any other way to say it.
Hey, RGT85. Hey, Sean.
Oh my God, it's Stevie Richards! So yes, the movie is called Doom Annihilation. It will be releasing in 2019, and this is an exclusive trailer of We Call It Hell in HD. Now, looking at this trailer right now, it doesn't look all that great. There's 10,000 views on it, 279 thumbs up, 3,200 thumbs down. So we're not off to a great start, but you know what? I'm willing to keep an open mind. Let's check out this trailer together. All right, so Universal Studios is doing it. Wanted, Doom Slayers. Pause. All right, so we're 6 seconds in, and I'm not really impressed with what I saw. That looked like some very terrible CGI, and it seems like we have a female lead character. Now, admittedly, I don't care about a lead character's, you know, age or race or sex when it comes to a movie, but when it comes to things that have source material, I do find it that it is a little bit odd, considering that Doom has been around since 1993, and it's always been Doom Guy. It was always a Marine, a Space Marine, that was doing this, and it seems like we have a lead female character on here, and it's not a big deal to me, but for purists and fans of the franchise, I don't know, that might seem a little bit odd to have a lead female character in this movie adaptation of the game, but you know, I'm willing to give it a chance, but it is kind of weird in the context of course, how this game has played out throughout the course of humanity, but I guess Doom Guy never really had a great story to begin with anyway, so whatever. Let's move on. Your mission, don't die. We got some guns, we got some big guns here, we're going through areas. This all looks very, very cheap. It's not a game anymore. And pause. So we have a demon that is popping out here, and we also have a gun that is being shot. Let's look at this gun at the 17-second mark here. This looks like a prop for, like, you know, an at-home movie. It doesn't really look like something you would expect Universal Studios to put out. It just doesn't look very high quality. Like, looking at the gun itself, like, it doesn't really have any characteristics to it. It's just kind of very bland. And, you know, even the attire that's being worn. This is evidently a sequel to the other Doom movie, which is kind of weird because that movie wasn't really well received. I don't think a lot of people enjoyed that movie. Sort of a guilty pleasure, but to sort of continue on that, I don't know, not really interesting, but let's continue on. And pause. So, pausing here at the 20-second mark, this just doesn't look good. Like, it definitely looks like a film that was done by maybe a student or a very low budget. I don't know what I'm taking away from this, but moving on. They opened up a portal to hell. Wow. Coming soon. Okay, so, no, my God. That looked absolutely terrible. That looked like it had no budget whatsoever. Like, looking at the ship that comes in at the 1 second mark right at the start of the trailer, that literally looks like some of the worst CGI I've ever seen. It looks like a direct-to-TV sci-fi movie. Like, I've actually seen sci-fi movies that have better, you know, CGI than that. It just looks very generic. It looks very plain. It does look like there's a nice variety of demons, but some of these demons look like zombies. Like, it seems like there's going to be zombies in this movie as well. Looking around the 17, 18 second mark, you can clearly see that there's some fast moving zombies here, because zombies are evidently a big part of the Doom universe. And this just looks terrible. Like, I don't see any sort of redeeming qualities to this. It literally looks like a direct-to-TV sci-fi movie, and I think that's even being a bit generous with this. You know, obviously trailers are supposed to, you know, make you excited for a movie. They're supposed to really bring you into the movie, but this just looks like absolute trash. I don't care that it's Doom Girl and not Doom Guy anymore. You know, who cares about stuff like that? It is kind of weird when you look at it in the context of source material, but just the overall quality of this just looks absolutely terrible, and I will be looking at future trailers of this. Maybe I'll check it out whenever it releases on Amazon Video for free via Amazon Prime, but I have no expectations for this movie. It looks absolutely terrible. It might even outtake the Sonic the Hedgehog movie, and I know what you're saying to yourself, why haven't you reacted to the Sonic the Hedgehog movie? I'm waiting on a trailer. Once we get that trailer, we will react to it. But yeah, that's Doom Annihilation. Obviously, it'll probably be on the Razzies for 2019. Looks like a piece of shit, but maybe I'm wrong. So let me know in the comments section down below what you think of Doom 2019, Doom Annihilation 2019, and if you're looking forward to checking out this movie. And as always, thank you for checking out this video. Check out other videos on the channel if you haven't yet, and as always, I will catch you guys on the next one. Later.